Amiksha, Russia has been deploying its Sukhoi fighters. They are very well known across the world for being very hard to take on in aerial combat. And Ukraine doesn't have any jets to fight them. However, they do appear to have land-based aerial attack weapons with which they appear to have taken down a Sukhoi fighter. We saw also, the inverse is also true. Just a short while ago, Crispino had broken the story of a Sukhoi fighter that was bombing Ukrainian military installations. And then how can we forget in Zhytomyr, how Shavan had showed us after the Sukhoi bombardment, schools, cathedrals, residential areas had also been destroyed. So there is a pitched battle, Samiksha, going on in the skies above Ukraine. It's a one-sided battle. Only Russia has the aeroplanes to fight it, but Ukraine appears to have some land-based weapons. And that is why we're in this situation right now, where a Russian fighter jet has been taken down.
Ankit, even though it's a one-sided battle, you know, it's been going on, it's been raging for 11 days now. What really is on everyone's mind is what is the end game of this? So even though, you know, it is one-sided, we need to see, watch out for the stand that NATO eventually takes, because a lot of meetings also happening, one in Lithuania as well, with Antony Blinken currently in Lithuania holding back-to-back meetings. So yes, a lot of things to watch out for as far as European Union stand is concerned.
Definitely. In fact, the one request that Ukraine has made to NATO is that you declare it a no-fly zone and you not allow Russian jets to fly in Ukrainian airspace. But Russia says that if you declare a no-fly zone on Ukraine, we will construe that as an act of war. So NATO is really stuck right now with regards to Russians' air power. They know that Russia is dominant in the skies, but if they try to act for Ukraine's interest by trying to impose a no-fly zone above the Ukrainian skies, Russia may construe that as NATO entering the war and then may escalate this conflict, which is what we know they appear to want. In fact, right now when Antony Blinken was speaking, also he was at a country that has reacted to Russian aggression in the past and has moved to join the European Union and may also feel threatened if Ukraine gets taken over. And so we are at this situation right now where Russia holds all the cards in the skies. Ukraine is trying to stem it from using Sukhois and other jets, but at this moment it doesn't seem to be able to do so.
That's right, Ankit. And you know, even though the NATO leaders have issued very, very strong statements, do you think it has really transpired on ground? Because the NATO leaders have been constantly maintaining that even though we will supply, we will give medical, the military aid to Ukraine, they will not be sending troops, and the same is for US as well. Do you think there could be some change in stance with respect to that? And also, as you clearly mentioned about the no-fly zone, with the Russian president issuing a very stern warning to the NATO leaders, do you think there could be probably some change in stance when it comes to that?
Well, it remains to be seen. Hectic negotiations will be held now. We'll be getting back to this after a short report, Samiksha. Viewers, stay with us.